Let's be confident equal to C. We have solution if look at C lies between minus root of a square plus b square. Root of a square plus b square, or it is also called modulus C less than or equal to root of a square plus b square. Look at, I will tell an example. Look at, find the values of, look at the question, you will understand it. Find the values of k for which the equation will have at least one solution. At least one solution. Take one example. Suppose let us say 3 sin x plus 4 cos x equal to k. Equal to k. Suppose let us take this equation. Now look at here. Suppose if sin x is there, here you are writing minimum value, maximum value. Like that, for this expression, a sin x plus b cos x plus c, you have maximum and minimum value. Take this expression. Constant here is 0. So this is of the form a sin x, left hand side is function is the right hand side, always make it constant. A sin x plus b cos x plus c. So for this minimum value, you know minimum value is what? Suppose if it is like this, a sin x plus b cos x, his minimum value is minus root of a square plus b square. In extreme values, we have learned c minus root of a square plus b square. Here, for this left hand side, one constant is what? 0. So minimum value is minus root of a square plus b square. Here, a is 3. B is 4, that means minus root of 25. So minimum value is minus 5. Maximum value is what? Root of a square plus b square. If the expression is of type, remember the formula. A sin x plus b cos x. Minimum value is minus root of a square plus b square. Here plus c. In the previous chapter we have learned a sin x plus b cos x plus c. Minimum value is c minus root of a square plus b square. Here c is 0. Right? So this is the minimum value. That means this is maximum value is nothing but root 25. So therefore for the left hand side one, 3 sin x plus 4 cos x always lies between minus 5 and 5. Minus 5 and 5. So range of this one is minus 5 to 5. So left hand side expression range we will calculate. Minimum value is minus 5. Maximum value is what? 5. Therefore K lies between. This is K. K must lie between minus 5 and 5. That means K belongs to minus 5 comma 5. Minus 5 comma 5. This is what? If A sin x plus B cos x equal to constant is there, that C must lie between minus root of A square plus B square to root of A square plus B square. This is also called modulus C less than or equal to root of A square plus B square. This is the one. This is C, Amma. This is C. C is here. It must lie between minus root of A square plus B square to root of A square plus B square. First, calculate the range of this expression. Minimum value, maximum value. Range is minus 5 to 5. So K put in there. Suppose another example. Value sin x plus 5 cos x equals to, I have given 2k plus 1. 2k plus 1. This is the equation given. Find number of integer values. Find number of integer values of k. Find number of integer values of k for which the equation will have at least one solution. At least one solution. Now look at here. A is what? 12. B is what? 5. This side C. Look at this equation. C. C equal to 2k plus 1. C equal to 2k plus 1. That means calculate root of A square plus B square. Root of A square plus B square is nothing but root of 144 plus 25. That means this is nothing but 13. This is nothing but 13. So for the left hand side, you take left hand side. For LHS, LHS 12 sin x plus 5 cos x, we will find minimum value. Minimum value equal to minus root of A square plus B square minus 13. Maximum value is nothing but 13. Therefore, this left hand side always lies between minus 13 and 13. This value on the left hand side always lies between minus 13 and 13. First write the range of left hand side expression. Right? This is nothing but 2k plus 1. If it has to be a solution, 2k plus 1 must lie in this interval. 2k plus 1 must lie in this interval, right? As this is lying between minus 13 and 13, right hand side, whatever it is there, that must be a constant between minus 13 and 13. Bring this side. So this is minus 14 less than or equals to 2k less than or equal to 12. Cancel 2. That means minus 7 less than or equal to k. Less than or equal to 6. Now k lies in the interval minus 7 to 6. But the question asked is, what are the, how many integer values are there? Look at how many integer values are there. Minus 7, minus 6, minus 5, minus 4, minus 3, minus 2, minus 1, 0, 1, 2, 3, 4, 5, 6. How many integers are there? So this is here negative integers are 7 and then positive integers are 6. 13 plus 0. So therefore, number of integer values of k are nothing but 14 values are there. 14 values are there. 7 negative integer values, 6 positive integer values, and then 0 is also an integer. Number of integer values of k is nothing but 14. What are the set of values of k means you must write between minus 7 to 6. He is asking number of integer values of k. That means how many values are there? 14 values. Like that, whenever left hand side a sin x plus b cos x is there, minimum value is minus root of a square plus b square. Maximum value is root of a square plus b square. For this function, calculate the range. So this lies between minus 13 and 13. So therefore, this value is what? 2k plus 1. That must lie between minus 13 and 13. Yesterday also, sin x value, you know, left hand side sin x is there. That lies between minus 1 and 1. Like that, left hand side, this function is there. You have to calculate what is the range of this one. Then, if you know the range, substitute that value in place of this. Then you will get the k values. Like those type of models will be there. Next question. If the equation sin x 2 sin x less cos x equal to n will have a solution, then n belongs to dash. Now look at here, this expression is there. That expression you convert 2 sin square x plus sin x cos x equal to n. You convert this into a sin x plus b cos x plus c. 2 sin square x. Sin square x can be written as 1 minus cos, eliminate the square, 1 minus cos 2x by 2. So this can be written as sin 2x by 2 equal to n. So look at here, now you got of the form sin 2x minus cos 2x plus 1 equal to 1. So take LHS. For LHS, A is 1, B is minus 1, C is 1. Now this is of the form A sin x plus B cos x plus C. You can easily find the range of this one. That means minimum value is nothing but C minus root of A square plus B square. That means 1 minus root of 1 plus 1 root 2. Maximum value is nothing but C plus root of A square plus B square. That is 1 plus root. In the previous chapter we have learned. That means this left hand side will always lies between this left hand side value always lies between 1 minus root 2 and 1 plus root 2. 1 plus root 2. Now look at here. This is nothing but n. That means n lies between. N lies between 1 minus root 2 to 1 plus root 2. That means n lies in the interval 1 minus root 2 to 1 plus root 2. Right? Always make the function left hand side a constant right hand side. Left hand side function, you need to find the range. So some problems will be of form a sin x plus b cos x plus c. In the previous case, constant is not there. That's why minus root of a square plus b square written. So here a sin x plus b cos x, of course, here 2x is there, here 2x is there. Same formula, like that. Like that, the given one, you have to convert into a sin x plus b cos x plus c. And then find the range. That means this lies between this and this. For having solution, this constant must lie between this and this. Suppose, if this constant is more than 1 plus root 2, you won't get it. These both will not be equal because this is lying between this and this only. If n value is more than 1 plus root 2, then there will be no solution. Because if it exceeds maximum value, this value for any x you don't get. Like that, these models are. Next. Find values of k. For which the equation k cos x minus 3 sin x equal to k plus 1 will have a solution. Now look at. So for this one, like this you can do, or otherwise, formula is, look at. If you apply the formula, this problem will become easy. Equal to that side C you take. Then what is the formula? Modulus C less than or equal to root of A square plus B square. This is the formula. If this condition is satisfied, then solution will be there. What is C here? Modulus k plus 1. If you write like this, it will become easy. Root of a square. K square plus b square is what? 9. Right? So if this condition is satisfied, then there will be a solution. Now look at, I am squaring on both sides. Doing like this will be easy for this problem. Squaring both sides. Both are positive. That means square. So if you square on both sides, what you will get here? You will get k square plus 2k plus 1 less than or equal to k square plus 9. K square cancel. That implies 2k less than or equal to 8. That implies k less than or equal to 4. K less than or equal to 4. That is the answer. Therefore, k belongs to minus infinity comma 4. Less than or equal to 4 means from minus infinity to 4. All the values less than or equal to 4 will be the answer. Right? Whenever the equation is of form a sin x plus b cos x equal to c, then write modulus c less than or equal to root of a square plus b square. Suppose look at. Suppose look at. Find solutions of find solutions of suppose take one example number one suppose question is given like this sine x into cos 2x equal to 1. Suppose question is given like this. Sine x into cos 2x equal to 1. Suppose you have to find solutions of this equation. Now look at here. Sine x always lies between minus 1 and 1. Always you know that. Sine x always lies between minus 1 and 1. Cos 2x always lies between minus 1 to 1. Right? This number always lies between minus 1 and 1. This number always lies between minus 1 and 1. Now given that product is 1. So maximum value of sine x is what? 1. Maximum value of cos 2x is what? 1. So therefore product is given 1. When it is possible, so there will be solution. There will be solution only if sine x equal to 1 and cos 2x equal to 1, right? When there will be solution, if you substitute an x, this must be 1, this must be 1, because maximum value of this is 1, maximum value of this is 1. And minimum value of this is minus 1 if number 1. First case, this is 1, this is 1. Second case, when in one more case it is possible. When both are minus 1, when both are minus 1. Only when this is 1 and this is 1, solution is possible. Only when this is minus 1 and that is minus 1, solution is possible. There will be no other case where product will be 1, because minimum value is minus 1, maximum value is 1. Minimum value is minus 1, maximum value is 1. Solution will be possible when both are 1 or when both are minus 1. Right? So look at here. Is there any x possible such that cos 2x equal to 1? Sin x equal to 1, it must be cos 2x equal to 1. Suppose look at here, if sin x equal to 1, suppose if you take one angle, pi by 2, what is cos 2x value? Cos 2x value, it will become 1 or not? Cos 2 into pi by 2. That means this is becoming 0. That means when this is 1, this will not be 1, because cos 2x is becoming what? 0. That means there is no x such that if you substitute here, it will become 1 and it will become 1. Suppose you can conclude like this. Sin x equal to 1. What is cos 2x value actually? Cos 2x value is nothing. Cos pi, that is minus 1. Cos 2x value is what? When sin x equal to 1, cos 2x value is nothing but minus 1. Whenever sin x equal to 1, cos 2x will become minus 1. It will not become 1. So therefore, in this case, no solution. That means if you substitute any value of x, this and this both will not become 1 simultaneously. That means there will be no solution in this case. Suppose sin x equal to minus 1. Sin x equal to minus 1. Look at sin x equal to minus 1. Whenever sin x equal to minus 1, if you calculate cos 2x, this is nothing but 1 minus 2 sine square x. That means 1 minus 2 minus 1. That means whenever sine x equal to minus 1, cos 2x will become minus 1. Therefore, solution is nothing but all the values of x satisfying this equation. If we write all the values of x satisfying this equation, then this will be obviously minus 1. Therefore, for sine x equal to minus 1, you can write the general solution. For sine x equal to minus 1, you can write the general solution. What is this sine of minus pi by 2? Sine of minus pi by 2. Therefore, x equal to n pi plus minus 1 whole power n into minus pi by 2, where n is an integer. Look at, for these values, you take one value, n equal to 0, x is what? Minus pi by 2. Now, sin x value is what? Sin x value, if you calculate, sin of minus pi by 2, that is minus 1. Cos 2x equals 2. Cos 2 into minus pi by 2. So that is cos of minus pi. Cos pi, this is what? Minus 1. That means for all these values of x, for all these values of x, sin x will become minus 1 and cos 2x will become minus 1. Therefore, general solution of the given equation is x equal to n pi plus minus 1 whole power n into minus pi by 2. Look at here. Whenever sine and cos product is 1, problem will depend on the minimum and maximum values. Only possible when this is 1, 1 case. This and then this is minus 1 and this is minus 1, another case. There will be no value such that if you substitute here, if you substitute here, product will become 1, because maximum value is 1, minimum value is minus 1. What you will get here, this into this is 1 means what? Both must be minus 1 or both must be 1. Like that, these problems will depend on the extreme values of the function. Suppose take another example. Find the number of ordered pairs. Look at, find the number of ordered pairs, x comma y, where 0 less than or equal to, 0 less than or equal to x less than or equal to 2 pi comma 0 less than or equals to y less than or equals to 2 pi, such that t power sine x, look at very important model, sum into 2 power cos x, greater than or equal to 6, look at, like this it is given. So x is lying between 0 to 2 pi, y is lying between 0 to 2 pi. You have to find ordered pairs x comma y, such that if you substitute here y, if you substitute x here, if you substitute y here, if you multiply this one, it must be greater than or equal to 6. It must be greater than or equal to 6. Right? So if you look at here, sine x always lies between minus 1 and 1. Sine x always lies between, you know that, sine x always lies between, cos y always lies between minus 1 and 1. Now look at here, when this product will be maximum when sin x equal to 1 and cos y equal to 1. This will be so look at here. This sin x lies between minus 1 and 1. Right? And cos x lies between minus 1 and 1. So now look at here. If you substitute here sin x equal to 1 and cos y equal to 1 and cos y equal to 1, then it will be maximum. Then it will be, you take here less than or equal to 6. Less than or equal to 6. Less than or equal to 6. Now look at here. If when sin x equal to 1, greater than or equal to 6 only. Greater than, look at the maximum value. Look at, if you look at here, maximum value of 3 power sin x into 2 power cos y is what? Substitute here 1 number. Substitute here 1, 6. Maximum value is 6. But given that greater than or equal to 6, greater than 6 is not possible. Therefore, only possibility is greater than 6 is not possible. Only possibility is equal to 6. How it will be greater than 6? There won't be any x and y such that this will be greater than 6. Because maximum value is nothing but 6. That means you have to calculate x and y such that this product is 6. For greater than 6, there won't be any x comma y. So only x comma y will be there such that this product is 6. For these you have to calculate when this is possible. Sin x equal to 1, this is possible only when sin x equal to 1 and cos y equal to 1. Sin x equal to 1 and cos y equal to 1, then this will become 6. Greater than 6, there will be no value of x and y. That means sin x equal to 1, I am calculating x values. Sin x equal to 1. So in 0 to 2 pi, only one value will be there. Only one value, that is pi by 2. In 0 to 2 pi, no value will be there. Only pi by 2. Cos y equal to 1. Y means when it will be y, when it will be 1, given that y is lying between 0 to 2 pi. Odd even multiples of 2 pi. Even multiples of 2 pi are how many? 0, 2 pi. Look at 90 is only possible for 1. You write the general solution and calculate. You will get this only. Cos y equal to 1 means always even multiples of pi. Even multiple means 0, 2 pi. So, two values of y are possible. Therefore, what are x, y values? So, look at x equal to pi by 2, y equal to 0. This is one possibility. X equal to pi by 2, y equal to 2 pi. Therefore, number of ordered pairs x, y equal to 2. That is the answer. Look at here. Substitute pi by 2. Substitute pi by 2. This is what? 3 power 1. 3 power 1 means 3 into 2 power 0. 2 power 1. 3 into 2 is what? 6. Next you substitute pi by 2 comma 2 pi. Pi by 2 here. This is 1. This is 3. 2 power cos 2 pi is what? 1. 3 into 2 6. That means such type of x comma y ordered pairs, how many are there? 2 values are there. Always when the problem is given, you think about the maximum value. What must be the value of sin x? What must be the value of cos y? As it is given greater than or equal to 6. Greater than 6 you will never get. Only you will get equal to 6. That means when it will be possible, when this is maximum and this is minimum. Find x comma y, find x comma y and write combinations. Here you got one. Y this. So, if x is this, y is this, one possibility. If x is this, y is this, another possibility. Like that. Very important model some of these are. For examination point of view, very important problems. Suppose you take another problem. Find the triplets. Find the triplets x comma y comma z. I am giving one problem. Look at. Find the triplets x comma y comma z. Such that 0 less than or equal to x comma y comma z less than or equal to 4 pi and 2 power cos x into 5 power cos y into 7 power cos z greater than or equal to 70. Like this problem is given. You have to find triplets x, y, z, right? So if you look at here, cos x maximum value is 1, cos y maximum value is 1, cos z maximum value is 1. If you substitute 1, what you will get? Maximum value of this 70. That means greater than 70 is not possible. Therefore, it must be 70. Greater than 70, there won't be any x, y, z. Right? When this is possible? When cos x equal to 1. When cos y equal to 1 and when cos z equal to 1, right? So what are the values of x such that 1? 1 means here even multiples of pi, how many are there? 0, 2 pi, 4 pi. Here even multiples of pi, 0, 2 pi, 4 pi. Here how many are there? Z equals 0, 2 pi, 4 pi. Now triplets, look at triplets. How many you will get? X can be taken these 3. 3 into y can be taken any 3. 3 into 3. That means 27 values. X you can take 0 or 2 pi or 4 pi. 3 ways. Y you can take any 3. 3 ways. Z you can take any 3. 27 triplets are possible. One triplet I am writing, look at 2 pi comma 0 comma 4 pi. Look at one triplet I have written. In these 27 triplets, this is the one. Right? X you can substitute here any 3, 3 ways. Y you can substitute any 3, 3 ways. Z you can substitute any 3, 3 ways. So totally how many ways? 3 into 3 into 3. If these are 3, these are 3, these are 3. Multiply 3 into 3 into 3. 27. Here also same. Here how many? 1. 1 into 2. 1 into 2. 2 values. Number of values of this into number of values of this. Number of values of this into number of values of this into number of values of this. So those many triplets you will get. Suppose take another problem. How many x comma y comma z comma w exists where 0 less than or equal to x y z w less than or equal to 10 such that two power, problem is given like this. 2 power sine square x into 3 power cos square y into 4 power sin square z into 5 power cos square w greater than or equal to 120 greater than or equal to 120 greater than or equal to 120. Now look at here, four variables are there, right? Now if you look at here, sin square x always lies between sin square x always lies between 0 and 1. Similarly, cos square y always lies between 0 and 1. Similarly, sin square z always lies between 0 and 1. Similarly, cos square w always lies between 0 and 1. Therefore, look at here. This maximum value is what? 1. So this maximum value is what? 1. This maximum value is what? 1. This maximum value is what? 1. So if they are 1, then 2 into 3 into 4 into 5 is nothing but 120. So greater than 120 is not possible. Only it can become 120. Therefore, when it is possible, it is possible only when sin square x equal to 1 and cos square y equal to 1 and only when they are maximum it will become 120. It will never be greater than 120. And cos square w equal to 1, right? So this is the one. So first one will become, look at, 1 minus sin square x equal to 0. Cos square x equal to 0. So cos x equal to 0. Second one will become 1 minus cos square y. That means sin square y equal to 0. This will become sin y equal to 0. This will become cos z equal to 0. This will become sin w equal to 0. Right? Now look at, cos x equal to 0 means, look at here, what he is giving, cos x equal to 0, 0 to 10. 10 means 10 radians. 10 means 10 radians. For cos x equal to 0, for cos x equal to 0, all you will get are odd multiples of pi by 2. Odd multiples of pi by 2. Look at what are the values, pi by 2, comma 3 pi by 2. Pi by 2, comma 3 pi by 2, comma 5 pi by 2. 10 means 10 value this one. Look at here, 5 pi by 2, calculate the value. 5 into 3.147 divided by 2. 5 into 3.147 divided by 2. That means 15 point something divided by 2. This is 7 point something. This is 3.147 divided by 2. It lies between 0 and 10 only. 3 into 1.5 something, it lies between. Next, if you write 7 pi by 2, 7 pi by 2, it will be 7 into 3.147 divided by 2. That means it will exceed 10. This value does not exist. How many? 1, 2, 3. 3 values. So here x, how many values? 3 values. Now sin y equal to 0. Multiples of pi. That means y equal to what you will get? 0, pi, 2 pi, 3 pi. General solution is what? Y equal to n pi. Multiples of pi. 0, pi, 2 pi, 3 pi. These are the values. Now again cos z equal to 0. Again this is the one. Z equals to what you will get? Same case. Pi by 2. All even multiples of pi by 2. 3 you will get. Pi by 2. Now sin w equals 0. Same is the case. W equals to all multiples of pi. 2 pi, 3 pi. 2 pi, 3 pi. So how many this 4 possible x, y, z, w. So, how many possible x, y, z, w number of equal to, here how many 1, 2, 3, 3 into, here how many 1, 2, 3, 4, 4 into, here how many 3 into 4. So this is the one, here 3, here 4, here 3, here 4, 3 into 4 into 3 into 4. So 16 into 9, 144 possible. One example I am writing, look at one example I am writing, this is 3 pi by 2, like this it will be. So this is pi, this is pi by 2, this is 0. This is one example I have written, right? X is 3 pi by 2, y is pi, z is pi by 2, w is what? 0. Like that, whatever I have written, like that 144 will be there. 144 will be there. Always, whenever it is given like this, take maximum values, then only it is possible. Then only it will be possible. Like this type of model sum. Find the number of solutions of number 1. Suppose question is given like this. Two sin x equals to x square minus 2x plus 3. What he will give is left hand side one trigonometric function he will give, right hand side one quadratic he will give. Look at, whenever this is given, that depends on the extreme values of these functions, maximum and minimum values. Take LHSM, take LHS. LHS always lies between minus 2 and 2. LHS minimum value is what? Minus 2. Maximum value is what? For this minimum value is minus 2. Maximum value is what? 2. LHS always lies between minus 2 and 2. Take RHS. So x square minus 2x plus 3. Always convert into perfect square. X square minus 2x plus 1 plus 2 I am writing. Right? So x minus 1 whole square plus 2. X minus 1 whole square plus 2. This is always greater than or equal to 2. Because this is positive 1. Right? This is always greater than or equal to 2. It will be 2 when this is 0. Otherwise it will be greater than 2. Now you got LHS always less than or equal to 2. And RHS always greater than or equal to 2. Now both will be equal. How it will be possible? Given that both will be equal, they will be equal, there will be solution. There will be solution only when LHS equal to 2 and RHS equal to 2. Only solution will be there when both are 2, right? You have to calculate x for which both are 2. That means when you substitute x, this must be 2. When you substitute x, this must be 2. Therefore, 2 sin x equal to 2. Solution will be possible only when x minus 1 whole square plus 2. RHS means this only 2. Only possible for a value of x. This must be 2, this must be 2. So now look at here, what is the x value here? X value is 1. So RHS will become 2 only when x equal to 1. When x equal to 1, but for x equal to 1, will this become 2? 2 sin x is what? 2 sin x is nothing but 2 sin 1. 2 sin 1 is not 2. 2 sin 1 is not 2 because only 2 into 1 you will get 2. 2 into sin 1 means sin 1 radian. That means when x equal to 1, this is becoming 2, but this is not becoming 2. So there will be no x such that this will become 2 and this will become 2. Therefore, no value of x. No value of x. Therefore, no solution. No solution. Look at, I will explain once again. Here one function will be given, trigonometric function. Here one quadratic expression will be given. You take LHS. This is simple function. Find the range of this one. It lies between minus 2 and 2. RHS quadratic is there. You convert into perfect square, plus or minus constant. Now I can write like this. So you can conclude that this is always greater than or equal to 2. LHS always less than or equal to 2 and RHS greater than or equal to 2. That means both will be equal only when LHS equal to RHS equal to 2. LHS equal to 2 and RHS equal to 2. That means only solution is possible when this is 2 and this is 2. So you have to find x such that this is 2 and this is 2. For this you are getting clearly x equal to 1. For this only one solution is there, x equal to 1. Right? For this x equal to 1, if this becomes 2, then that will be the solution of the given equation. That means x equal to 1, if you are calculating 2 sin x, you are getting 2 sin 1 which is not equal to 2. Therefore, that means what? Both cannot be simultaneously 2. Right? That means there will be no solution. Suppose x equal to 1 here, look at 2 sin 1. This is what? 2. They both will not be equal. That means no solution like that. For this x value, this is 2, then that will be solution. So for this, no solution. Like that, one quadratic equation and one trigonometric function. Calculate range of this one, this, calculate range of this one by converting into perfect square. Look at next problem. Find the number of ordered pairs. Ordered pairs theta belongs to 0, 4 pi. 0, 4 pi ordered pairs r comma theta. Theta belongs to 0, 4 pi and r is a real number such that, very important modulum, such that (2 sin theta) = (r^4 - 2r^2 + 3). Like this it is given. So you have to find ordered pairs r comma theta, where theta is lying in this interval and r is real number. That means if you take one r and theta, if you substitute here, they must be equal. If you substitute theta here and if you substitute r here, both values must be equal. Such type of r comma theta you have to find out. Now look at LHS. Whenever trigonometric function is given, you take 2 sin theta. This always lies between, because sin theta lies between minus 1 and 1. This always lies between minus 2 to 2. Now take RHS. What is that minimum or maximum value? (r^4 - 2r^2 + 3). I am writing like this. Look at (r^2 - 1)² + 2. Right? So I will adjust like this. Look at (r^4 - 2r^2 + 1 + 2). This is nothing but convert into perfect square. r square minus 1 whole square plus 2. So look at here, this is perfect square. That means this will always be greater than or equal to 2. This will always be greater than or equal to 2. Therefore, LHS you are getting less than or equal to 2. LHS is always less than or equal to 2. RHS is always greater than or equal to 2. Therefore, solution will be there. Solution exists when LHS is equal to 2. And when both are 2, only solution will exist. And RHS is equal to 2. That means LHS is equal to 2 means 2 sine theta equal to 2. And 2 sine theta equals to 2 and r square minus 1 whole square plus 2 equal to 2. That means what are the r values? R you are getting plus or minus 1. Now theta you calculate here, both are different variables. Huh? Sin theta equal to 1. Now I will calculate what is theta value, general solution. Sin pi by 2. Sin pi by 2. You write general solution. Minus 1 whole power n into pi by 2. Different variables. This is r, this is theta. Right? If you look at here, n equal to 0. N equal to 0 means you will get theta equal to pi by 2. N equal to 1. Again, pi minus pi by 2. Again, you will get pi by 2. N equal to 2. Right? So, n equal to 2. What you will get? 2 pi, 2 pi. Plus pi by 2, that means 5 pi by 2. So next n equal to 3, you will get 3 pi minus pi by 2. Again this is pi by 2, then you won't get n equal to 4, let us say. N equal to 4 means 4 pi plus pi by 2, not possible. Because he has given in the interval 0 to 4 pi, therefore how many values are possible? Pi by 2 comma 5 pi by 2. Pi by 2 comma 5 pi by 2. Pi by 2 comma 5 pi by 2. How many values of r are possible? Minus 1 comma 1. Now r comma theta, how many values are possible? Right? So r values are 2 into theta values are how many? 2. How many? 4. How many? 4. Right? That means how you will get, look at r comma theta means I am writing like this. What are those values? Minus 1 comma pi by 2. Minus 1 comma 5 pi by 2. 1 comma pi by 2. 1 comma 5. 1 comma 5 pi by 2. 4 values like this. These are the 4 values. Now look at minus 1 comma pi by 2. If you substitute in the equation, look at what happens. Look at here. Theta pi by 2, 2 into 1, 2. R value is what? 1 minus 2 plus 3, 2. If you substitute this r comma theta in the equation, both LHS and RHS will be what? Equal. Like that, 4 values will be there. 4 ordered pairs, r comma theta will be there. Like that. These type of problems will depend on the extreme values. Trigonometric function, quadratic function. You find the range of this, find the range of this. This is less than or equal to, this is greater than or equal to. So this must be 2, this must be 2. Calculate the values like that. Now look at some problems will be there where you have to apply AM greater than or equal to GM. For A comma B, positive numbers, AM greater than or equal to GM. AM greater than or equal to GM. We will use this concept in some problems for finding the minimum value or maximum value. A plus B by 2, this is arithmetic mean. Geometric mean means greater than or equal to root AB. Suppose take one example. Find the number of solutions. Of the equation number one, first example, two cos square x by 2. Sin square x equal to x square plus 1 by x square. Zero less than or equal to x less than or equal to pi by 2. Look at the equation. 2 cos square x by 2 into sin square x equals to x square plus 1 by x square. Look at here. LHS, you got 2 cos square x by 2 sin square x. Right? Like this it is there. Now you know that cos square x by 2 is always, cos square lies between 0 and 1 and sin square lies between 0 and 1, right? So maximum value of cos square is what? 1. Maximum value of sin square is what? 1. Therefore, LHS we can say that always less than or equal to 2. Always less. Maximum value of this is what? When this is 1, it will become 2. LHS is always less than or equal to 2. Right? You can say clearly. Because maximum value of this is what? 1. Maximum value of this is what? 1. LHS will be less than or equal to 2. Now take RHS. RHS is nothing but x square plus 1 by x square. Now I am applying AM greater than or equal to GM. This is A, this is B. For these two numbers, I am applying AM greater than or equal to GM. Therefore, x square plus 1 by x square greater than or equal to 2. Therefore, you got RHS greater than or equal to 2. LHS is less than or equal to 2 and RHS is greater than or equal to 2. Therefore, solution exists. When LHS is equal to 2 and RHS is equal to 2. Then only solution will be possible. That means 2 cos square x by 2 into sin square x equal to 2. LHS is equal to 2 means this must be 1. And RHS is equal to 2 means this must be 2. Right? Now, if you simplify this one, you will get x power 4 plus 1 equal to 2x square. If you bring this side, x square minus 1 whole square equal to 0. X equal to plus or minus 1.
right? So x square equal to 1, that means you will get x equal plus or minus 1. So when this will be 2, when x equal to 1 or minus 1. Now if you look at when x equal to 1, when x equal to 1, if you substitute here, for x equal to 1,
cos square x by 2 into sin square x, this is nothing but, will it become 1? Cos square 1 by 2 into sin square 1. So this is not 1, this is not 1, that means not equal to 1. So similarly, for x equal to minus 1, LH is not equal to 1. Similarly, if you substitute minus also, this product you won't get 1. That means there are no values of x such that this is 2 and this is 2. There is no x such that this is 2 and this is 2. That means what? Therefore, no solution. Therefore, what is the answer? No solution. No solution like that.
Whenever the shortcut is, whenever left hand side one trigonometric function will be there, right hand side a number and its reciprocal will be there, sum. In that case, the answer is no solution always. For any problem, on the right hand side, x square is there, reciprocal is there. Like that, a number and its reciprocal is there, number of solutions are zero. Because for these values, you won't get this value too. That's why common x value will not be there. It satisfies both. Like that, these type of models. When the number and its reciprocal is there, apply AM greater than or equal to GM. AM greater than or equal to GM for these models. Look at next model. If tan of phi cos theta equals to cot of phi sin theta, then cos of theta minus pi by 4 value equal to dash. Look at this problem. This is given like this, right? So what I am doing is I am taking this angle as A equal to pi cos theta, and this angle as B. So question is given tan A minus cot B equal to 0. Tan A minus cot B equal to 0. Now I am applying sine by cos. Sine A by cos A. Sine A by cos A minus cos B divided by sine B equal to 0. Now you are getting sine A sine B minus cos A cos B equal to 0. This is nothing but minus cos of A plus B. If you take minus common, so therefore cos of A plus B equal to 0. That means A plus B is what? General solution. So this is theta. Cos theta equal to 0. What is the general solution? 2n plus 1 pi by 2.
cos theta equal to 0.
Cos theta equal to 0 means theta equals to 2n plus 1 pi by 2. Now substitute here.
So a plus b means I am getting pi into cos theta plus sin theta equal to 2n plus 1 pi by 2.
2n plus 1 pi by 2.
Look at here. This and this will get cancelled. This and this will get cancelled. Cos theta plus sin theta equal to what you are getting? 2n plus 1, where n is an integer.
Now he is asking this one. Look at. Whenever a cos theta plus b sin theta is there, you multiply and divide with root of a square plus b square. Root of a square plus b square is what? Root 2.
So root 2 into 1 by root 2 cos theta plus 1 by root 2 sin theta equal to 2n plus 1. 2n plus 1. So therefore root 2 into, this is cos pi by 4. Into cos theta plus sin pi by 4 into sin theta. This is nothing but 2n plus 1.
Now this is cos of theta minus
2n plus 1 by 2. Cos of theta minus pi by 4 equals to this root 2, bring this side. 2 root 2. Where n is an integer.
So look at here. So you got this one. Look. If you look at here, n is what? Integer. Substitute n equal to 0.
What you will get? Cos of theta minus pi by 4 is nothing but 1 by 2 root 2.
You must get a value between minus 1 and 1. Cos. This is possible.
Now n equal to 1 if you substitute. What happens is, cos of theta minus pi by 4 is nothing but 3 divided by root 8. 3 divided by 2 root 2. That means this is root 9 divided by root 8. This is greater than 1. Not possible. This value we cannot take. Because cos can never be greater than 1. So this is one value. Suppose if you substitute n equal to minus 1. What you will get? So minus 1 means minus 1 by 2 root 2.
This is possible. This is a value between minus 1 and 1 only. So therefore you will get two values. What are the possibility of values?
Therefore, cos of theta minus pi by 4 is nothing but plus or minus 1 by 2 root 2.
Like that, after writing general solution, this cos is there, that must always lie between minus 1 and 1. You keep on substitute the values and then take what are the values between minus 1 and 1. These are the two possible values. Look at next model. look it up. Next. Trigonometric equations where modulus function, is involved. Look at in trigonometric equation, you will get modulus. What is modulus? X is positive value. X, I mean non-negative value, of X. It will not be negative. It will become zero or positive. That means, suppose modulus 3 is there. You will write positive value of 3, that is 3. If modulus minus 3 is there, then also you will write it as 3. Modulus 0 is there, that is 0. That means modulus x will always be greater than or equal to 0. Modulus x means if x equal to 0, it will become 0. If x is positive 3, then it will be 3 only. If x is negative, modulus of x is what here? Negative. That means then also we will write 3 only. Modulus x will always be greater than or equal to 0. Modulus x means when x is negative, you will write minus x. Look at here. Modulus minus 3, you have written minus of minus 3. When x is negative, it is minus x. When x is positive, x, when x equal to 0, it is what? 0, like that, right? So whenever modulus x is there, you have to take the cases like this. When x less than 0, this only you can write like this also. Because when x equal to 0, minus x is what? 0. When x greater than or equal to 0, x is what? 0. You can write 0 anywhere, no problem. Right? When modulus x is involved, two cases must be taken. When x less than or equal to 0, minus x. When x greater than or equal to 0, x. Right? Whenever modulus x is there, you take two cases. It will be, look at here. Modulus of x, x is what? Negative. Answer you have written 3. That means minus x. Modulus of 3, you have written same x. Here you have written minus x. X is minus 3. Here you have written minus x. When modulus x is there, take one case. X less than or equal to 0, it is minus x. When x greater than or equal to 0, it is x. Whenever modulus x is there, you take two cases. You will get again in function sum. Just you learn the this one. Modulus x means always positive. So when x equal to 0, it will become 0. Look at in our problem. Suppose equation is like this. Look at. Suppose look at, find number of solutions of equation given modulus cos x minus sin x equal to 2 cos x in 0 comma 2 pi. Look at here. Modulus of cos x minus sin x
equal to 2 cos x. So here modulus function is involved. So this is modulus x. You treat this as x. Modulus x. Modulus x. So case 1. Case 1. So when cos x minus sin x, take this case. First case. Look at this is x. Whatever modulus is there inside, that one is x. Treat it as x. So first case. When let x less than or equal to 0. Let x less than or equal to 0. Then this will become minus x. Right? This is nothing but 2 cos x. First case. This. So that means this is minus cos x plus sin x equal to 2 cos x. 2 cos x. Now look at, bring that side. Bring that side. Sin x equals to. So sin x equals to. Look at here. Sin x equals to 3. Sin x equal to 3 cos x. 3 cos x. That means here you are getting tan x equals to. Tan x equal to 3. Tan x equal to 3. So here you got tan x equal to 3. Tan x equal to 3. Tan x you got positive quantity. Look at tan x you got positive quantity. Tan x you got positive quantity. Right? So tan x you got positive quantity. How many solutions will be there? How many solutions will be there? In 0 to 2 pi, look at here. Tan x, you don't know the value. That is the problem. Tan x equal to 3, you got positive. Tan x equal to 3, you got positive. That means 0 to 2 pi means one rotation. 0 to 2 pi means one rotation. That means x will lie in the interval quadrant 1. Here it will be positive. So here it will be positive. Here it will be positive. That means x can lie in quadrant 1 comma quadrant 3. X can lie in quadrant 1 and quadrant 3. Right? So in quadrant 1 and quadrant 3. Now tan x equal to 3 is there. Tan x equal to 3 means here one solution. And here, one solution will be there, right? Here one solution will be there. Suppose, let us say in quadrant 1, okay? X belongs to quadrant 1. X belongs to quadrant 1. Now, we will check whether tan x equal to 3 in quadrant 1. Let us take tan x equal to 3. Tan x equal to 3. Tan x equal to 3. Now we will calculate in quadrant 1 what is sin x and cos x. So what is sin x and cos x? Tan x equal to 3 means, look at 3 divided by 1. This is what root 10. That solution must satisfy this also. Cos x minus sin x less than or equal to 0. Now what is cos x here in first quadrant? Cos x equals to 1 divided by root 10. 1 divided by root 10. First quadrant positive. Sin x equal to 3 by root 10. Now calculate cos x minus sin x. Cos x minus sin x is what? 1 by root 10 minus 3 by root 10. That means minus 2 by root 10 less than 0. Right? That means if the angle is in first quadrant, cos x minus sin x less than 0. Therefore, one solution in quadrant 1. One solution in quadrant 1. Next, suppose x belongs to quadrant 2. X belongs to quadrant 3. X belongs to quadrant 3. Let us say whether solution is there or not, we will check. X belongs to quadrant 3 means, x is negative and y is negative. That means tan x is 3, x is negative and y is negative means you have to write like this, minus 3, minus 1. Minus 3, minus 1. That means this is what? This is root 10. In quadrant, this leg must be negative, this leg must be negative. Now calculate cos x. Cos x is nothing but minus 1 by root 10. Sin x is nothing but minus 3 by root 10. Now calculate cos x minus sin x. Cos x minus sin x is nothing but, in this case, you will get minus 1 by root 10 plus 3 by root 10. 2 by root 10. This is positive. That means for quadrant 3 solution, cos x minus sin x is what? Positive. So therefore, no solution. This solution must not be taken. No solution in quadrant 3. Look at here. If this is given, if this is only there, then this is one solution, this is one solution. But it must satisfy cos x minus sin x less than or equal to 0 also. Solution must satisfy this condition also. That's why in quadrant 1, I have taken tan x equal to 3 and calculated cos x and sin x. For that, you are getting less than 0. That means in for quadrant 1 solution, cos x minus sin x is less than 0. But for quadrant 3, in quadrant 3, when tan x equal to 3, I have calculated cos x and sin x. That means cos x minus sin x, what you are getting? Positive. That means this solution in quadrant 3 will not satisfy this one. Therefore, in this case, how many solutions are there? Only one solution. Right? So, therefore, when cos x minus sin x less than 0, how many solutions are there? One solution in quadrant 1. So, similarly, we will take cos x minus sin x greater than 0. Case 2. In the first case, one solution in quadrant 1. Second case, cos x minus sin x greater than 0, greater than or equal to 0, second case. Now this will take plus x. Cos x minus sin x equal to 2 cos x. Now look at here what you will get. Bring that side, minus sin x. Now you will get the value easily. Minus sin x equal to cos x. So tan x is what? Minus 1. Tan x is what? Minus 1. Now here you know the value. Look at, I will calculate. Previously I don't know the value. That's why all these problems. Now you know the value. Tan x equal to minus 1 means I will write the general solution. Look at. Here you can calculate what is x. Minus pi by 4. So x is nothing but n pi plus alpha. N pi minus pi by 4. In 0 to 2 pi I will calculate. N equal to 0. N equal to 0 means minus pi by 4. This is not there in 0 to 2 pi. N equal to 1. N equal to 1 means pi minus pi by 4. This is there. So this is there. Right, this is nothing but 180 minus 45. This is 135 degree. Now n equal to, let us say 2. N equal to 2. That means 2 pi minus pi by 4. This is nothing but 360 minus 45. So this is nothing but 315 degree. So this is also there. You got two solutions. Right, you got two solutions after solving tan x equal to minus 1. But these solutions, for these solutions, whether this is satisfied or not, you check. Cos x, you have to check whether satisfies or not. Cos 135 minus sin 135. So this is 135 is nothing but 180 minus 45 minus sine 180 minus 45. This is what 180 minus theta. That means minus cos theta. That means minus 1 by root 2 minus of 180 minus 45 sine 45 minus 1 by root 2 minus 2 by root 2. So therefore this is minus root 2 you are getting less than 0. Therefore x equal to 135 degree is not a solution. Because it must be greater than 0. Then only we have written this one. Cos x minus sin x. Therefore x equal to 135. He is not satisfying cos x minus sin x greater than 0. Let us take x equal to 315 degree. Let us take x equal to 315 degree. This is nothing but 360 degree minus 45 degree. I am calculating cos x minus sin x equal to cos of 360 degree minus 45 degree minus sine of 360 degree minus 45 degree. Cos of 360 minus theta, that means fourth quadrant, that is cos 45 1 by root 2 minus sine of 360 minus theta, fourth quadrant, that is minus sine 45. That means you are getting 1 by root 2 plus 1 by root 2 is nothing but 2 by root 2. That means this is nothing but root 2. Therefore, it is satisfying greater than 0. Therefore, x equal to 315 degree is one solution. Right? So, when cos x minus sin x less than 0 is taken, you got one solution. When cos x minus sin x greater than 0 is taken, you got one solution. Therefore, number of solutions of the given equation equal to That means 2. Like that in the trigonometric equation, whenever modulus x is involved, simply you take two cases, right? When x less than or equal to 0, you write modulus x equal to minus x and then solve the trigonometric equation. Finally, whatever you will get the solutions, you check that condition. Here you got solutions. You have taken the case where cos x minus sin x greater than 0. For the solutions you got, these you check whether cos x minus sin x is greater than 0 or not. You take those solutions only where in that case cos x minus sin x greater than 0. In the previous case also, you got two solutions. But for only one solution, that condition cos x minus sin x less than or equal to 0 is satisfied. Like that, whenever modulus will come, take two cases. Look at one more problem. Look at find x comma y. Where x belongs to 0 comma 2 pi. You have to find ordered pairs x comma y. X belongs to 0 comma 2 pi. Y belongs to 0 comma 2 pi. 0 comma 2 pi. Such that you will get two equations like this. You will be given sine square x plus sine square y equals to 1/2 and x minus y, it will be given like this, equal to 4π/3. There will be two equations. Here x and y is there. Here x and y is there. All of you listen carefully. Tomorrow from morning 7 to 8, 1 hour class will be there. One day I have taken leave now. Tomorrow I will cover some miscellaneous problems. Don't miss tomorrow. At 10 there will be exam. Look at this problem. So now how to solve this is, look at this sine square x is there, sine square x. Let us take, this is equation 1, this is equation 2. First equation is sine square x is nothing but 1 minus cos 2x/2, 1 minus cos 2y/2. This is 1/2. 2 cancel. 2 cancel. Right? Look at 1 minus of cos 2x plus cos 2y equal to 1. 2 minus. That means cos 2x plus cos 2y equal to 1. Now cos C plus cos D. 2 cos C plus D by 2. That means x plus y cos C minus D by 2. X minus y equals to 1. Now look at here, x minus y is given as 4π/3. 2 cos of x plus y. 2 cos of x plus y into cos of, this is 4 into 60, 240 equal to 1. Look at here, this value is what, 240 degree means, I am writing this as 180 degree plus 60 degree. 180 degree plus 60 degree, 180 degree plus 60 degree, that means I will get 2 into cos of x plus y equals to, x plus y equals into, cos of 180 plus 60 means cos minus cos 60. This I am getting 1. Therefore, cos of x plus y equal to minus 1. X plus y equals to minus 1. Now look at here. I can write what is x plus y. X plus y is nothing but minus 1 means odd multiple of pi. Now look at here. Given that x lies between 0 and 2 pi, y lies between 0 and 2 pi. Right? Given that x lies between 0 and 2 pi, y lies between 0 and 2 pi. Now you can say, add this. X plus y lies between 0 and 4 pi. 0 and 4 pi. Therefore, what are the odd multiples of pi in 0 to 4 pi? Therefore, what are the values? X plus y equal to pi comma 3 pi. Pi comma 3 pi. Look at cos of theta equal to minus 1. Theta must be odd multiple of pi. x plus y is lying between 0 and 4 pi. Therefore, what are the odd multiples? Pi and 3 pi. Now look at here. X minus y, you know. X plus y, you know. First case. First case. X plus y equal. This is 180 degree. This is 180 degree. And x minus y equal to 240 degree. Add this. 2x equal to, if you add this, what you will get? 240 plus 180. 320, 420. That means x value is nothing but 120 degree. X value is nothing but 120 degree. Therefore, substituting here, y value is what? 60 degree. This is one ordered pair. X is 120 degree, y is 60 degree. Second case. X plus y equal to 3 into 180. 3 into 180 means 540 degree. X minus y equal to 240 degree. Add this. 2x equals to. 2x equals to. Here you will get 540 plus 240. How much? 580 plus 200. 780. Therefore, x value is nothing but, so x value is nothing but 390 degree. 390 degree means it is exceeding 0 to 2 pi. Therefore, this is not possible. Therefore, this is not possible because x is lying between. X is lying between 0 and 2 pi only, but you are getting 390. So, therefore, this is not possible. That means only x and y are what? X is 120 degree, y is 60 degree. This is the only values possible. Right? So, like that, tomorrow I will tell some miscellaneous problems. So, 7 to 8, 1 hour. 1 hour class will be there. Don't miss. Thank you all of you. Have a nice day.